Good day everyone, my name is Leanne, I'm a registered pharmacist from South Africa. Today I want to discuss with you on how to correctly advise your patient when using an asthma pump. So I took an OTC asthma pump and I'm just going to use this as a reference. All of them are similar to each other, but always advise your patient or yourself, if you are uncertain, to check the package insert of your specific product. Okay, now let's get straight into it. Let's look first at the parts of an asthma pump. So you're gonna have the mouthpiece has a protective cap, okay? So it can be removed. Very important, the dose counter. There you see the dose counter. Why is this important? It's gonna tell you when you have to get a new asthma pump, when this one is almost finished. Okay, so for people chronically relying on this type of medication, they have to know when to get a new one, and so they don't run out of breath. Okay, then you have the actuator, which is this plastic part, and then this is an aerosol containing your active ingredient. In this case, I'm showing you one that has salbutamol in it. Okay, so the process of taking or using an asthma pump is as follows. So first, you're going to remove the cap of your mouthpiece. So here, I'm removing the cap of my mouthpiece. Then you shake it gently, just a few times, and you spray two sprays into the air. Okay, one, two. Okay. Now the patient is going to position the hands correctly on the device. So they advise you to put your index finger here and your thumb there. Doesn't matter actually how you do it, as long as you have control when this device is put into the mouth. Then the teeth will come around this area. You don't have to necessarily bite, just rest the teeth here and the mouth will cover the remaining openings, okay? The patient has to breathe out thoroughly before he puts this into his mouth. And then as he presses down on the active ingredient or on the aerosol, breathes in slowly, okay? After the spray has been sprayed in the mouth, can remove the mechanism or the pump from the mouth and keep the breath for as long as possible. After the breath has been kept for as long as possible, can exhale slowly. Okay. If another dose needs to be administered, wait 1 minute and repeat the whole process again. I also quickly want to mention on how to clean your inhaler. This is one step that patients and pharmacists don't always talk about or remember to tell their patients to do. And you think it's kind of obvious because you're putting this thing in your mouth, you better clean it, hey? But it's not mentioned that often. So let's just quickly run through the steps. So, if you want to clean this inhaler, you're going to remove the aerosol from the actuator, right? You can put it in lukewarm water. You can immerse both the actuator and the cap in water. And you can rinse it thoroughly. And after you rinse it, they also advise you to make the tap running, and then you make the water run through the actuator from the here and also from the mouthpiece. And then you let your actuator air dry, okay? After it's been dry, you can put back the part and you can put back your active ingredient. They recommend you to do this at least once a week, especially if patients are using it frequently. All right, I just quickly want to say a few things regarding the pump. This isn't one we usually recommend, okay? It's given OTC, but patients will come and ask for it, right? We usually give syrup with salbutamol, so on. Asthma shouldn't be treated over the counter. The patient should see a doctor and get proper treatment, especially something with a short-acting beta agonist like salbutamol. You don't want to give this long-term because it can cause desensitizing of the beta receptors, which is not wanted in a disease like asthma. Okay, so if you're seeing your patients are constantly coming back for this and using it very much, very often, more than recommended, you can advise that patient to go see a doctor and tell them that you think they might have an asthma problem or some airway disease. Maybe they can just consult a doctor and check, because this isn't the correct long-term treatment for asthma. It's basically when you have, when you're on treatment and you get that breakthrough episodes, or only maybe for a short while that you use it, but not often, as often as most, some patients, not most of our patients, some patients do get it. So yes, that's it from my side. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you have any comments, please leave it for me in the comment section below, or questions or concerns or anything, I'll get to you. I'll answer you as soon as I can, and you must have a wonderful week.